Welcome to Simple Stress and Strain, Professor Ravi, module number 1. Here, numerical on varying section will be continued for the last video, wherein this particular total number of problems will be solved. These problems are the previous old examination problems. First problem, a steel rod 20 mm dia and 800 mm long is rigidly attached to an aluminium rod 40 mm dia and 4 meter long as shown in figure. So there are two types of rods, one is a steel rod, another one is a aluminium rod. The combination is subjected to tensile load of 40 kN. So the tension load is of 40 kN. Find the stress in the materials and the total elongation of the bar. E for steel is given as 200 GPa and E for aluminium is given as 70 GPa, that is gigapascal. So now we have to see the figure. So the figure is shown in the question like this. So whereas it is mentioning a steel rod of 20 mm dia and 800 mm long. So we can see steel rod of 20 mm dia and 800 mm long. And similarly, aluminium rod of 40 mm dia and 1000 mm long. 1000 mm means 1 meter long. And both are subjected to, combination is subjected to a tensile load of 40 kN. So both are subjected to tension of 40 kN from other end, and both are connected at in between. Clear? So solution, the free body diagram of each section is to be drawn. This is the free body diagram for the above problem, wherein we can consider steel as one part and aluminium as one part. When we consider the force of 40 kN is acting away from the member, similarly on the other end, the same amount of force 40 kN is again acting away from the member itself only, that is away from the end. So for that reason we consider 40 kN is acting equal and opposite in the direction. So this is for same steel section as well as same for the aluminium section, it is acting equal and opposite direction. Now when we consider these two 40 kN, if they are acting equal and opposite, means there is no difference of the joint between aluminium and steel member. Continuing further, stress in steel we have to determine. So stress in steel is given by sigma s is equals to ps upon as, that is pressure force acting on the steel divided by area of steel. We know the force is acting on the steel is 40 kN, so converted that into Newton as 40,000 divided by area pi by 4 into 20 square. So we are able to see that the stress in the steel is 127.32 Newton per mm square. Now coming to elongation in the steel itself only. Elongation is given as delta S is equals to PL by AE, that is now we consider it as force acting in stress PS, length of the steel S, LS, area of the steel S and E as Young's modulus of steel. Now how did we arrive at this particular equation? So when we see the particular part as the single thing, we are able to have the first of all the part. So we know that stress is equals to P by A, that is load upon area. We consider it as force acting and the resistance area. Now based upon this stress, if we go for the strain part, E is equals to, E is known as stress upon Young's modulus. So we substitute the value of stress in this equation, we are able to have P by A E is the particular strain what we are requiring. Now we require the change in length. So change in length is equals to whatever is the strain multiplied by the original length. So when we substitute the strain in this equation, we are able to have that as P into L divided by area multiplied by Young's modulus. So using this equation, we have framed particular this equation for the steel elongation. Clear? So substituting the values, force as 40,000 newtons, length of the steel as 800 mm, area pi by 4 into 20 square, then 200 GPa, that is 200 gigapascal. We are able to see that. So this GPa is nothing but 10 raised to 9. When we convert, is we comes out to be 200 newton per into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square itself only, as per the previous videos we have the conversions. So looking into that, the 10 raised to 3 plus, it is plus 10 raised to 3, it is coming as newton per mm square. So how it is coming to newton per mm square, I'll explain it. So 200, if it is a GPa gigapascal, 200 multiplied by 10 raised to 9, it will be coming. Pascal means it is newton per mm meter square. Pascal means newton per meter square. So this newton per meter square, we need to convert it into mm square. So meter square is divided by 10 raised to 6 for the conversion of mm square. So in this, this 10 raised to 6 gets cancelled. Here also 10 raised to 6 gets cancelled, and remaining is 10 raised to 3. So when 10 raised to 3 is going to come, we are able to see that 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square is the final value what we are able to see in the particular equations or substitutions. By substituting these values, we find the elongation in the steel as 0.5093 mm. Stress in aluminium, when we are going to find, the formula is for this, sigma A in is equals to force PA divided by area aluminium, and that is AA. Writing the substitution values, 40,000 divided by area of the aluminium, as considering pi by 4 into 40, the diameter is given as 40 square, then we are considering diameter square. So finding out the stress in aluminium as 31.8 newton per mm square. Similarly, elongation in the aluminium is also determined with the formula as delta LA is equals to PALA divided by AA and AEA. So what is PA is force acting on the aluminium section, LA is length acting on the aluminium section, AA is area of the aluminium section, and Young's modulus of the aluminium section. So we consider this as, so now here we can see this is the formula for the elongation of aluminium. Substituting the values, that as similar, we consider the particular substitutions of values. 40,000 is the force acting and 1000 mm is the length, then area pi by 4 into 40 diameter square, and 70 GPa. That is, we are able to get that 70 newton into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. So then we find out the total elongation of aluminium as 0.4547 mm. Calculating the total change in the length, when we are going to determine, this part is delta L is equals to delta LS plus delta LA, which we substitute the values when we have calculated in the elongation part earlier, we find out the total change in length as 0.964 mm. So in this particular problem, second problem, a bar is shown in a figure, is in three parts. Find the length of the L of the middle part so that the net extension is not more than 1 divided by 2000 of its length. Of its length they are giving, and Young's modulus is given as 195 GPa for whole three parts. So these are the three parts wherein we are able to see that one section is of 30 mm diameter, second section is of 20 mm diameter, third section is of again 30 mm diameter. Having a force of 60 kN on both the ends, that is acting 60 kN and 60 kN equal and opposite in direction. Determining is the part, is this particular middle part length. How much is the length of this particular middle part? We have to determine. So to determine, they have already given the external length of as 400 mm. So this external length of 400 mm is known to us. With this values, we can find out for the particular problem solutions using the further our equations of stress and strain. Solution: area of section 1 and 3, because both the diameters are same, I am calculating them in one equation itself only. 1 and 3 will be able to have pi by 4 into 30 square, which is 706.85 mm square. Then calculating the area of the section 2, A2, pi by 4 into 20 diameter square, 314.16 mm square. Similarly, total length is how much? Total length is 400 mm, which is given in the question. Extension required. Now, extension required is also they have given in the particular question, as it should not be more than 1/2000 of its length. 1/2000 of its length, it should not be more. So how we are going to calculate? 400 is the given length, and multiplied by 1/2000. When we do this thing, 1/2000, it is 400/2000. We are able to see that the value of extension required is 0.2 mm. So total extension should not exceed 0.2 mm when 60 kN of load is acting. Let the length of the middle part be L. So let us consider the middle part length as capital L for our inputs in the formulas. Length of the remaining parts, section 1 and 3, is equals to. So for this section and for this section, both together we will be considering 400 minus L. So this part section will be what? So this will be 400 minus L divided by 2, it is, for one side of the section. We are considering both the section at a time, because there is no change in the dimensions, there is no change in the force, and the diameter also remains the same. For that reason, we can consider that same amount of force is acting and there is no change. If there is a change in the force, then we have to consider separately section number 1 and separately section number 3. This we have to keep it in mind. So I am taking that both are same as 400 minus L together. Stress in the middle part. Now first we are going to find. So sigma is equals to P by A. Force is acting 60 kN. So 60 into 10 raised to 3. Divided by area of that particular middle part section, what we have calculated it, we are able to find out stress as 190.98 newton per mm square. Elongation of in the middle part, it is delta L2, L2 is section 2, PL by AE. 60,000, L as it is, we don't know what is the length, then area, Young's modulus 195 GPa, again converting it into newton per mm square. So 195 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square, or 195 and 3 zeros when we add on the further part, it is newton per mm square, is equals to 0.95 into 10 raised to minus 3 times L. It is minus 3 times L. Please take the answer as 0.95 into 10 raised to 3 times L mm it is acting. Elongation of the other parts. So delta L3. So stress is not required. The stress is we are not going to consider, because it comes as P by A itself only. That part we can see in this equation. So directly going for elongation, because elongation is the restraining part which is given in the question. Substituting the values, and we are able to see that 0.435 into 10 raised to minus 3 in terms of 400 minus L mm, we are finding the answer. Now, we are able to see delta L, the total elongation, as delta L2 plus delta 1 and 3. So 0.2 is the total elongation as per the question. Calculating and equating those equations with these equations, delta L2 and delta 1, 3, and further, if we go on simplifying the values, we are able to get the particular length of the middle part as 50.48 mm is the length of the middle part. Third question, a steel wire of 1 mm diameter stretched horizontally between two fixed points 1.6 meter apart is added upon by a vertical load applied at a midspan. The load causes a vertical displacement of 40 mm at a load point. Determine the load applied and the stress induced in the wire neglecting weight of the wire. Take E is equals to 210 GPa. 210 GPa is 210 gigapascal. So this part of the figure is here. So we can see this particular figure. Two fixed ends are there. This is the wire which is of 800 mm and 800 mm. Exactly at the center point, a P force is acting, which will try to take the wire to the deflection, means to the movement of displacement about 40 mm. Then we have to determine what is the amount of tension is acting in this particular wire when it is coming in the downward direction. And when we consider the particular movement, we are able to see a small angle of alpha is going to created at the supports, which we consider alpha on A, and same similar alpha is on the B end support. A support and B support both are of fixed type of supports. Solution: a steel wire is stretched between the two fixed points. We are able to see it, and diameter of the particular wire is only 1 mm. Only 1 mm we have to remember, and it is in terms of diameter, so area will be able to calculate. Diameter is 1 mm, length is 1.6 meters. Delta is this 40 mm and E is 210 GPa, 210 GPa. So this 210 GPa will be equal to 210 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square will be the particular value, which will be more part of easiest thing we can calculate. Let P be the vertical load. So P is acting as a vertical load, which is in the particular question given as this particular part of P, which is the vertical load acting in the problem. Tension in the wire, so it is capital T, we have marked it already, but let us see how we are able to calculate how much is the tension force acting in the wire. So tension in the wire is calculated. Tan of alpha, tan of alpha is delta upon L by 2. So when we see tan of alpha is this part, delta divided by half of the length, this section. We are able to calculate the tan of particular alpha. So when we substitute delta as 40 mm, length as 1600, that is 1.6 meters, 1600 divided by 2, we get tan alpha as 0.05. Then further, also P, force P is equals to 2 times of T, tension, and it is sine of alpha. P is acting in the horizontal direction. So when we consider it in the vertical direction, it is acting, sorry, P is acting in the downward direction. P is acting in the downward direction and tension is acting in this direction. Okay. So when we consider this part where it is the alpha in this direction and alpha is at this point, when we resolve this, it is going to come in this direction. When we are resolving it in this way, it will be sine of alpha. It is sine of alpha of T. So T sine of alpha. So T sine of alpha are how many now? 2T times of, 2 times are there. So 2T sine of alpha we are going to consider for the counterpart of force to the downward force, which is again nearly the small alpha. Alpha is very small, so we will substitute it as tan alpha itself only. So substituting 2 times t into tan alpha value as 0.05. So we get that 2 into 0.05 multiplied by is 0.1 times t, or t is equals to, now when we calculate the tension, it is coming as 1 divided by 0.1 is 10 p. So 10 times p is acting in the tension force. Load calculation. Now still we don't know what is the p, we know only the tension part. Stress in the wire p by a, that is sigma is equals to p by a, substituting p as in terms of 10 p, and this particular the tension in the wire we are going to calculate, it is t. P is tension which is acting in the particular wires, then area of that particular wire. So we are able to get this as 12.73 times P. Though it is Newton per mm square itself only, we are not writing because force is not known what is, whether it is in Newton or in what it is going to get. So this we are not having, for that reason no units are written. So units are, we are not writing for this, for a particular section, still we get the answer. Okay, strain in the wire is equals to AD. So this part we have to understand. So once again, if I draw this particular section, not so clearly but bit roughly, this is somewhat A C B and D. So AD minus AC, strain in the wire, divided by AC. So AD minus AC is equals to, we need to find what is AD minus AD is how much now. So if I able to see this particular part in the section, this figure, so here we can see this part as AD, AC, and C is 40 mm, this is 800 mm, this is B, D, and this is A to B point. Okay, so how we are going to consider this in the section? So here we can see this part we will be considering, this is 800 mm as we have seen in the figure, this is also 800 mm as we have seen in the figure, and this part is 40 mm as we have seen in the figure. So 800, what is AD? I am telling, it is in the Pythagoras theorem, this is the total 90 degree we are able to get. We are calculating AD value, AD, so square root of 800 square minus plus this 40 square. So how it will be, that is AD is equals to square root of AC square plus CD square. So this value is substituted here directly, minus 800, 800 is what, AC value, A to C, divided by AC value, again 800. So we get the strain in the wire as 0.00125 mm, this is the strain in the wire. E, that is Young's modulus, we already know that stress upon strain. So when we calculate in the reverse order, that is part, we already know that the thing of stress and strain, this is 210 GPa. So substituting those values as the Young's modulus, we get that particular P value as 2013 newtons. So this is the value of force which is acting. Now calculating the stress, so we get that stress as 12.73 P, we have already calculated. Substituting that in this stress equation, we get 12.73 into 20.13, so 256.3 Newton per mm square. Thank you and see you in the next video. Till that, repeat the things and problems